How much air pressure is in an inflatable toy? The answer will surprise you, as it isn't very much at all. The warning label on a typical pool toy warns to keep the toy below 30 millibar, or about half a PSI. Here's an Intex Orca Whale and an Intex Great White Shark ride-on pool float. The gauge pressure required to keep a toy inflated is basically zero. When the toy is softly inflated, the air inside is supporting the minimal weight of the thin vinyl material that makes up the toy. This is why a toy deflates so slowly if not actively squeezing the air out of it. With a minimal pressure difference, there is little motive force to expel the air. The toy only begins to hold in a measurable pressure when firmed up or ridden. Squeezing the whale a bit only causes the pressure gauge to measure a little over a tenth of a PSI. When I sit on the whale, the pressure inside it jumps from nearly zero to about half a PSI. If I bounce around on the toy, the pressure gauge spikes to 0.65 PSI. But that is still a very low pressure if you compare it to the 8 PSI of a basketball, or the approximately 30 PSI of a car tire, or 60 of a bike tire. Inflated to its rated pressure, the whale looks more like this. This is why the manufacturer says not to inflate the toy such that all the wrinkles go away. As the pressure increases, the toy feels both firmer and tauter. You can feel the pressure and how firm it pushes back when you push into the toy, while you can sense tautness by whether it feels pulled tight like a drum and how high pitch it resonates when you give it a flick or squeak your fingers across it. If I sit on the toy again, the pressure changes from about 0.35 to 0.7 PSI, and spikes to about 0.8 if I bounce on it a bit. This is probably a bit too high for the toy, and is probably permanently stretching it out. I'll show more on that in a bit. Now, how does the size of the toy affect all this? Well, here is a larger whale from Inflatable World. At 3.2 meters long, it is almost double the length of the classic Intex whale. If you like this content, consider giving it a like. And if you want to see more, please subscribe. Just like with the smaller toy, the pressure to keep the larger toy nearly full is almost zero. But note how this time, the pressure gauge barely moves when I push or squeeze the whale. Because the whale is so much larger, the pressure goes up a whole lot less when I squeeze it. This makes it seem significantly softer. The same effect is seen when I sit on the barely inflated toy. The pressure goes from nearly zero to about 0.2 PSI, and I am only able to get it to spike to about 0.3 when I bounce on it. Next, I attempt to inflate the large whale to the same pressure the small one is rated for. It seems way too tight. In fact, I am not even able to get close. The whale just keeps growing bigger at just above 0.3 PSI. With all that additional surface area, the same pressure can build up much higher tension forces in the material of the toy, making the toy feel much tauter and causing the vinyl to stretch. This is why larger inflatables are more susceptible to bursting from overinflation. The same air pressure causes more stress. To achieve the same tautness, the toy does not need as much air pressure. Notice how much higher pitch the squeaking sounds of me rubbing the larger toy is, despite how much lower pressure it is. When I sit on the larger toy again, the pressure changes from about 0.2 to 0.3 PSI, and spikes to about 0.4 if I bounce. Notice how much less this is than either the pressure of me riding the underinflated or firmly inflated small whale. This is why a larger toy, despite having similar feeling vinyl to a smaller one, will always seem like the softer toy when inflated. Now that we know how toys behave at normal pressures, how much pressure can they take? Here I overinflate an Intex Great White Shark ride-on. As can be seen, the pressure goes up quickly at first, but the increase starts to slow even though the toy continues to stretch. the pressure can sometimes even start to decrease as the toy stretches more rapidly. That is a sign that the toy is about to burst. This Intex Lil Blue Whale is made of thinner vinyl than the Shark and does not hold as much pressure. As you can see, a tear inside starts to propagate out from the hole that inflates the fin. This T-Rex inflatable is entirely constructed with pinch seams and has several tight negative curves. It unsurprisingly blows out at the tight curve between the neck and chin. The small shark springs a leak in front of its fin, resulting in the whole fin splitting open. I hope this video has piqued your interest. And as always, leave any tips or suggestions in the comments below. Consider supporting my channel by purchasing a t-shirt from the link in the description. Thanks for watching.